Hello everybody, this is going to be the second part in the Neo Zeong review. And before I show the Neo Zeong itself, I had an idea when it came to what I talked about at the end of the Sanaju portion with the bazooka and the shield. And like I said, can't connect the bazooka to the shield and have the Sanaju hold it. And this is what they show you in the instructions, but then I remembered you can put a polycap ball joint up here. That's what it was made for the alternate mode. So if you take the holder connector, plug it in up there, all of a sudden you can have the bazooka on the shield that the freaking arm would connect to. That would be super duper. There we go. You can have the bazooka on the shield at the same time. No problems. So, and I looked and I did not see it unless I completely missed it on the instructions. It didn't show that anywhere. So, yes, you can do it. You just have to have extra polycap ball joints, because I don't think you have enough after everything is said and done. But yeah, you can do it, so that's even better. Now, on to the Neo Zeong parts. Well, first we gotta get this guy into his pants. So here is the base of the Neo Zeong. Now, you'll see it does have a stand. The stand is like any other SD stand, and it does come with the normal connector, so you could put it on the Sanaju if you want. But this one comes with a special connector made for the SD Neo Zeong. You can see some nice detail down here. Pretty good. So just peg it right in there. Now the Sanaju is going to peg into there via his crotch. And you do have to remove the fuel tanks to get him to fit properly. And just get his feet situated in there. Peg them in. And there we have it. So now he's standing in his stilts. Now, you could theoretically have his arms and shoulders connected at the same time. They just peg into ball joints back here. I think it's better and safer for the Sanaju not to do that. Because I did try, and I was really worried about breaking something. So the shoulder and arm pieces, like I said, you just peg them into the back, and at the same time, you can kind of put them over the shoulder of the Sanaju. Like that. Connect very well. In fact, I probably should have used these... Oh, it's in there. I probably should use these for some other parts that are on ball joints, but anyways. Take it in, like that, and now to cover everything up, you have the front section. Basically, this big section is going to go into the crotch, and then these holes here will tab into sections right back here behind this panel on the shoulder. So plug in the crotch piece first, and then peg in the shoulder. And also make sure the hands are out of the way. And there goes an arm. There goes a panel. See if I can do this properly. There we go. Yeah. And there. Get these panels back on. Like that. Ugh, these panels do not like to stand. It might be because, I don't know, the gray piece might not be in there all the way. Alright, now we're almost done, because we gotta come back here. And this is gonna be a problem, and annoying. But I'll do it anyways, because of course you have the extra arms that go on the back. Now these are all with polycap ball joints, and they're really a big pain. I swapped several out for ones I've had in a container to try and get better ones, and they all kind of suck in here. It's not the ball joints, I don't think. And these still fall out. It is the fact that they are connected very precariously on here. So, I'm going to put this one. I think I had a connector that was... It should be ones that don't show the plastic, the hollow piece. Yeah, there we go. That one there. And then these two over here, try not to jostle the thing so it falls apart back here. Okay. And then finally, oops, you take the shield, and we'll get rid of this, and I'm gonna have to get, let's see if I can get that out. Can I get it out? Yes. So we're gonna take that piece that I had the ball joint, and it's gonna go into the peg right here in the middle. For the shield, without knocking things over would be super. There we go. And there, my friends, is the SD Neo Zeong. All put together and looking very awesome. And the body itself, once you get the front piece pegged in the crotch and the shoulders, it's pretty solid. Pretty solid. The arms, on the other hand, are very, very loose. This guy's already flopped over. Surprised I haven't fallen off yet. The stand does a very good job of holding this weight. It's a pretty solid kit with everything on it. That is for sure. So yeah, I am surprised it's actually holding together with those arms in the back. Now, in terms of the articulation, of course, the head's the same. The arms are immobile. These arms are not. They're ball-jointed at the shoulder, and also ball-jointed at the elbow, but you can really only bend them. And the fingers can rotate. They're on ball joints. You can do a little bit of wiggle if you pull them out. And even the fuel tanks are ball-jointed, and if you want... This force is going to make those arms fall off, I know it. Oh, no, it didn't. You've got the thrusters molded in there, just like in the anime, when it lost the fuel tanks. I guess I'll show these now, get it over with. These panels are supposed to come out and peg up like that. So it shows I'm thinking these are missiles. It didn't use them, that I remember. But what you can do is take this new bazooka, pull off the end, and if you notice, there's little teeny... I don't know if you can see, there's little teeny holes on either side. There's these little teeny bars here. And they just fit right in like that. Now this is why we should have gotten two. Because, well, what do you do with this one? Not much. You can have it open, but you don't have a bazooka. So that's a little annoying. And actually, these doors hold better up than they do closed. There goes an arm. So, yeah. Now, let's talk about these arms, since one just fell off. You do have the swivel here, because these are pegged in for different reasons. And this is a store mode, if you want to actually use them. These are kind of, they're not really pegged in, they're kind of grooved, like in grooves. And it is hard to get out. What can I use? It might work. You just got to kind of pry them out. And they have ball joints. And you just basically slide them in. Now these are actually plastic ball joints, they're not polycab ball joints, that's the thing. These are hard plastic. And I'm thinking I might switch them and put them into the actual, into the arms themselves. I think that might work better. I'm pretty sure they were made for the hands. I'm pretty sure they said that. Unless I misread it. And in that case, I'm complaining about nothing. But yeah, so you can peg them on like this. So you have them like that, or into the other peg, which bends them. So you can have them over the shoulder. Like that. Which is pretty cool. Freaking panels, man. Freaking panels. Actually, let me just do this all off camera. So here's the Neo Zeong with all of the kins facing forward, ready to just kill everything. Just everything. And those parts on the sides, the holes, are definitely designed for this. You can see how they're cut. So the groove kind of faces that way. And I did, while I was changing the hands around, I did swap the polycap ball joints from the arm pieces into the hands and vice versa, and the plastic ball joints didn't work. There was no friction. They weren't even big enough. So it just fell right out. So you do need to use polycap ball joints. I would just say fill around and hopefully you get ones that fit better in here than some other ones. Well, the ones that are like this, they seem to be made for this configuration. They hold a lot better. And also, when you're putting these parts on, I do find if you push them in when they're up, and then slide them down, it holds a little better. Although it does, oopsie, it does kind of create a gap a little bit. I think I'm going to have this pushed in all the way. That could be the problem. Now, there are a few more things that come with the Neo Zeong. You get two halos. Now this one is from the anime. When it used the... I'm not gonna actually spoil it. But this one you have to put over... It's actually works really good in this configuration. The other way you have to kind of fiddle with the arms. But these holes here, and there's a hole in his bum right there. And they're basically gonna fit into those holes. Actually, I lied. It doesn't work well this way. Let's take these off first. I might have to take the other arms off too. I think I do. It's hard to do with the arms on. It's even hard to do with the shield on. But I should be able to. It also makes the kit a little more solid. It was pretty solid before in terms of the body, but with these parts pegged in, it's really not going to come apart. Although you can't. Yeah, this is the one problem. You can't really have your cannons forward now. But it doesn't mean you can't have them backwards. And ready to crush the banshee. Aw, sad arm. Sad arm is sad. Don't be sad, you have friends. It's fine, be that way. Okay, so yeah, there is the ring. And it does come with this one. This one basically goes on the shield. That connector that I've used several times for different equipment, you can actually use this. It just pays into the top tab. Or like that, and now he is a god. Or an angel. I think I know what they were going for. If you see the end of the OVA, I think I get it. It didn't use it in any attack, but I think I understand. Maybe. So that's pretty much it. Now, I didn't mention the stickers. You get a few more stickers. You got the little one in the middle here. You got the one in the stomach. You've got 5 on the skirt armor. And then you've got a little teeny Neo Zeon one on his butt. And that... Oh yeah, and also the white ones on the fuel tanks. So not too many, really. We'll see on the lower half. And that is pretty much it. I think if you want, you could connect the fuel tanks back on here, because, if I can show it, there's holes here. Now, I think they would fit polycap ball joints rather well. Let me see if I can find one in my pile of stuff. We'll just get into the old container full of polycaps. This is what I use to store all the extra ones. You never know when you're going to need one. And there's a polycap ball joint. So we'll just peg it in there. And see if this will hold. And it's a little loose, but yeah. So you can have the... Because if I remember correctly, I don't remember the OVA, but I do remember screenshots of the 6th episode at the end when they're building the Neo Zeon, and they show the fuel tanks sticking out from the back. So this would totally do that, if you wanted to have fuel tanks, which I think I do. I don't want to have them laying around. See if I have another polycab ball joint sitting here. There we go. So, once again, I don't think you have enough polycaps to actually do this in the kit. So, if you do save your extra ones, well, there you go. This ring also helps with holding the hands on. It kind of hits them and rests them on there. So I guess it does help some other things. So that is, from what I can remember from the OVA and all the stuff you get, that is basically it for the Neo Zeon. Let's do some comparisons. You can see how huge he is now. Here he is with the normal Sananju. Yeah, he grew. He grew up. He ate his spinach and his Wheaties. Yeah. And I brought in some other kits. We got the Banshee. Not the one from the last episode, but it's still a Banshee. It was the closest one to get. And it's, I guess its predecessor, the perfect Zeon. So yeah, a little bit different. And because it is a mobile armor, how about another famous one? Dendrobium. Yeah, look at that. Even the Dendrobium SD, which is a pretty big SD, is nothing compared to the Neo Zeon. So that is the Neo Zeon SD. It is a pretty massive, awesome SD. You get a fully functional Sananju. You have a big, pretty hefty armor when the Sananju's inside. It looks pretty good. It does have some nice gimmicks. The effect ring, which you had to pay extra for the high grade. The arms are probably the weakest point, literally, on the kit. Because as you can see, they just really flop there. Unless you had a really lucky time with the polycap ball joints, these are going to be a big problem. You can probably fix it with some, like, nail polish or put some super glue on them to thicken them up and let them dry and then put them on. Maybe. Little hidden things like putting the fuel tanks on there is cool. Like I said before, the bazooka for the Sinaju, they should have had two. You have the places, you need another one. But overall, it is a pretty cool super deformed kit. It is more expensive, quite a bit more expensive than a normal SD. But I think after watching this, you can understand why. So that is about it, and I'll see you at the next review.